Okay, I'm gonna do a sort of a reloading video, and it's more or less a video for myself, because notice like the 35 self-loading, it's I don't have dies for it. It's sort of a series of dies here, and like there's several different calibers I do this kind of thing with, and you eventually forget. Like, how do you really, how do you do this sometimes? Like, I haven't loaded in a while. I kind of recently just, I think I just loaded up a few rounds there. I got a few cases here that Log Cabin Looms had sent me a few years ago. And, like, original Winchester Repeating Arms Company ones. I initially tried to reload some of them back then, and I lost a few because they split as soon as I tried to bell them out. So I had gone through and I had kneeled them all. So I've got these ones here, so I'm gonna reload those. But I go through and do another video. I have one that's from years ago that's seems to be a bit out of date, but I'll go through. I'll exactly mention what shell holder, what dies I'm using, what I'm accomplishing here. Might be help to somebody else as well. This video probably won't, well, I think I'll post it on YouTube, then I'll import it onto YouTube. So I like to mention that as well, that I'm posting or putting a lot of my old videos over there. I'm gonna try to get all my reloading stuff over there, because YouTube probably does have another one of their big pogroms and goes through and gets rid of my channel or gets rid of those videos or whatever, that be a copy of them. So on my main page on the top, there's a little link there. So if you want to go over there and subscribe, I got like 7 subscribers or something, but that's just kind of funny. I think some of the videos over there have more views than they do on the YouTube side, which is kind of weird. But so all right, so I've got the originals here, but all as a test subject here. I'm just going to load it without powder, stuff like that, because that's just pretty straightforward stuff. These are made out of 38 Special Winchester Western. I annealed these as well. They were with these ones or whatever, but I annealed them at the same time, I think, because they were having a lot of these. When I fire them, they start to crack up here because they were quite old before they were converted. And I'm thinking these might have issues when I fire them, but we'll see. I'm going to load up a few and try them out. But this is what we want to accomplish with the 180 grain converted bullet. This bullet here. It's a 35 Remington Lee mold with the gas check milled away. But it's almost a perfect clone of the, even like the sort of the jacket or the jacketed soft point 35 self load, and was quite flat faced like this, the same sort of shape. It's better than like the 351. They rounded it off more later. But so we're gonna load up this casing here with this bullet to emulate this, and show you how it's done. So these cases were fired in the 35. They've been deprimed because when I annealed them, I wanted them not to get water in there. I dried them out. So we got a number 19 Lee shell holder, which is for like 9mm and stuff like that. It will work with the originals, work with the converted 38 Special. So I got that in the press here, my rock chucker. First we start with it's probably best to start with this. You start with a 9mm carbide die, or like 38 Special I think would work as well. The 9mm should smoosh down a little bit more. This one doesn't have a decapping pin, but it's not a big deal. But it should have a decapping pin at this stage. There's a patch of cap, or a spent cap in the case here. So you put that there. Run that through all the way. Take that out, take that die out. Sorry for the noise here. Then we want, because that's not small enough, because 9mm is like 355, somewhere around there. Our bullet is 352. Jacketed ones are like 351. That size, it takes kind of, if there's any lumpy, bumpy things down at the lower part of the case, that is sufficient to take that out. So then we go to a 222 Remington die, which is the one I found that seems to work the best. And of course you could use case lube in this operation if you wanted, but we just want to size it about halfway, kind of to the, where that line is there on this case. Just to give the bullet a little bit of extra neck tension. So we just put that in there. Run that about halfway. And size it down to about there. Take that die out. Go with that. Then we need to bell the case mouth. And, you know, there's obviously, like, the priming stage and stuff. I'm not going to worry about that. This is the Lee Universal Expander. You use the, let's see, it's this orientation. It's the bigger plug with the smaller one pointing up for this short of the case. So we run this in here. We got these all pre adjusted here. Put that in there. Run that through. See that? Belled that. Check it with your bullet. Bullet. Base the bullet just gets started, so that's perfect. I'm going to shave lid. Let me take this out. See, it's a lot of. Could have a press that holds multiple dies. It's probably a lot easier. So then we got your cedar die. This one is a 38-357 Magnum cedar die. So you put your case in, put your die in here. Your bullet, make sure your bullet is started properly. There we go. Seated it, and it did seem to actually roll crimp it a tiny bit, which I didn't think it would do it, but it, well, I guess the case is not that much smaller. It did roll crimp it a tiny bit into that crimping groove there, and you can see, I don't know if you can see it or not, but there is a bit of a bulge behind the bullet because we sized the case down to here with the 222 die, so give it a little extra smoosh so you get your bullet has good, your bullet's not going to back in or anything. That was an added, you can, I don't know if you really have to do this or not, but you got a Lee factory crimp die for 9mm, so it does like a taper crimp. You can use that on this, and it'll kind of, if your roll crimp gets kind of, I don't know, a bit excessive or something, you might have a bit of a lump here, so it might, I don't know, cause feeding issues. Just run that die in. Run this through it, and you can see it. You can see the mark it makes. It kind of taper crimps it and smushes the brass into the bullet a little bit. So that's got really good purchase on that now. Now it is kind of, you know, it's bulges and stuff, but they all, it'll still chamber okay. It's just because that's smaller than it really has to be, so it kind of bulges, but that, you can see the bottom of the bullet there, but that kind of, you know, it gives it good pretty hard for the bullet to get pushed back into that, but the Winchester self-loaders don't seem to have issue with, you know, bullets being shoved back and stuff like this. But anyway. So yeah, so that's the different dies you need to load this. The only difference is you need to put your primer and your powder in it. We'll see if we can get the rifle here and show the chambers. Here's the 35 self-loading mag. You can see that it's perfect length. The flat is just behind that little spacer there. And that's a dummy, you know, it's not loaded ammo or anything. See, no hesitation at all. It throws her out. So, works perfect. In semi-autos, you want the case to be a tiny bit small anyway. Like, it's not a thing where you want to mess around with just, like, sort of try to neck size and stuff. But, and blowback guns, like, this isn't really a high intense load or anything. As well as loading, you know, hotter loads, might be a bit more of an issue. You might get a little bit more bulging or something down lower here or something. It would interfere with it trying to chamber and stuff. But because I don't know, the original cases, I guess, yeah, they're a bit more, I'm sure they're quite a lot thicker than these 38 special, but. Anyway, so that's the process I go through to load 35 self-loading, different dies I use. It makes pretty acceptable ammunition, in my opinion. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys.